Welcome back to another video. So today we are going to create a table in PostgreSQL and go over some basic queries, the create table, insert into table to get data into there, and the select statement, from statement, where, and how to join them together to create some queries. So before we start creating a table, we'll need to quickly go over database types. So for database types, if we go back to the documentation that I talked about in last video, and in my last video, I went over how to download and set up PostgreSQL. So if you want to follow along, you can go back to that video, download your own database so you can learn SQL, create a database, figure out how to add data into there. But we'll need to shortly go over data types because they're extremely important. And a lot of these you won't really use, but the ones we're going to use today will be varchar, which is the alias for character varying, which means any characters that are text will create a variable length character string. There can be numbers, but you have to put it into a string, which will just be like basic text, like a school, John, like names, a city. And for like something like age or like a monetary value, you can either use integer. You can use numeric, which has decimal places, so that'd be good for money. There's a money type in itself. Those are the ones we'll be using. Date's another very useful one. If you have a date table or want to add, you know, the year, month, the day. And there's text, and then there's real time and some other ones, but we will not be using them today. And to find this is if you open up the documentation page, go to data types, scroll down, it will take you to this page and give you a description of the types. But so now that you have a short intro into data types, it will open up PostgreSQL. This is starting off exactly where we left out. So this is a dashboard that has different pages, but what we're going to want to hit is our database to go down to this one. And then from here, we're going to hit the query tool. And this will take us to a little page where we can write our own queries. So the first thing we're going to have to do is create a table. To create a table, we're going to use the syntax create table and then a table name after. You don't need to make these capital, but it does help to distinguish like what is a statement and what is just text. So create table and then the name of the table. So we'll just call it first table. And there are certain words that you're unable to use, like you can't use create table create because it will think that you're trying to create another table. So it won't work. There are some words that are used for syntax and can't be used as a table name. So now we just put parentheses, and you can type it like this, but I also like to create some space down here, so then anything in here will just also be in the parentheses. So the first column of the table, we'll just create first names, first name, and then after the column name, we need to add the type. So we'll do varchar, which is a varying character, and then the length. So we'll make it 20 because no one's first name is probably longer than 20 likely. So then you need to put a comma, then you can just hit enter to create a new line. We'll do last name, also varchar, and we'll do 20 as well. And this just states that anything longer than 20, the database will not accept. Then we'll do the age, and we can do an int for that, just an integer. And then city, we can also do varchar 20 as well. But you're going to want to end your statements the semicolon, just to tell the database to that's where the statement ends, so it'll only run to there. So you can either highlight something to run it, So if we add more, which you'll see in a little bit, you're just going to want to highlight, but we can just hit run. So after we execute, return successfully in 70 milliseconds. This is how long a query takes to complete. If you have complex ones, they'll take quite a while. But to visualize this, so from this database, we're going to want to go down to schema. So after schemas, you're going to click tables. We actually need to refresh this. So what you're going to want to do is hit refresh. And then from here, go down to tables. So if you right click this, it'll give you a bunch of options. But if you click view or edit data, you can click all rows and it'll start its own tab over here. And so here's our column name in the type of data type it is. So it's a character varying, last name, age, city. So if we just close out of here, it'll take us back. So now what we're going to want to do is an insert into the table. So if we just type insert into and the table name, so it'll be first table. It is case sensitive. So make sure that if you have a capital F, this is also capital F, and that also goes for column names. So then just parentheses again. We'll just go down to create the row that we can type in. You need to then either state which columns you're gonna add into. So for this example, we will do that, but if there's a certain amount of columns already in the table, in this instance, it's 4, you can just type 4 values. But for this sake, we'll go first name, last name, age, city. So those are the columns we're going to insert. So then from here, we just type of values in parentheses. So now the values are being added into in order, first name, last name, age, city. So if we type the name John, this won't work because without a single parenthesis around, it's just the data type is just text. So if we put double parentheses, it won't work either. So we need to put a single parentheses, and you'll see that after we put a single parentheses, it makes everything after it like a dark orange color. And so now only that's dark orange. So that is a character varying that will just be a text data type, which is what we want. So John, and then we can type another single parentheses, which automatically completes. We'll just do last name Jones. So age will be an integer, so we could do 45. And then the city will also be single parentheses. We could do Atlanta. So from here, we can just hit comma, bring us down to another line, and just hit tab to bring us a little farther in. And for this one, we could do more names. So first name with single parentheses, last name also with single parentheses. So we could do Jim, and then we could do Dale as his last name. And 50 as the age, more single parentheses, we could do New York. So now if we hit semicolon, that will end the statement. And then whenever we highlight all of this and hit run, it returns successfully. So we inserted these values in order into this table with these columns. But so now if we delete this part, and then let's change it to Tim, Johnson, and delete this row. We'll just add one more line into, we'll make him age 60, and we'll make him from Boston. So now if we also run that, run successfully, it's a kind of the same thing. Since there's four columns and four values, it just puts them in order. But if you want to insert into a specific column, you can add it here like we did before. Okay, so now let's refresh. So if we go up to the database and hit refresh. Now go down to our tables, all rows. You will see the values in the table. So we will quickly go over how to select data from them. So this query is select all, the star means all from, and then our table will we'll address it and retrieve data from it by saying public. That's the schema of the database that they gave us. So it'll be the public database dot first table, which is the table we created. So if we close out of this one and we can run our own select. So select is how you retrieve data. It's the most useful statement in SQL. Can do select, and instead of doing all, which is the star button from the database, from the table, we can just add first name. So after you select a column, you need to do the statement from. So we're selecting this column from the table. So we just saw the table in there was public dot, and now the table name. So first table, you need to spell it right for it to work. So if we highlight that, hit execute, it returns us the first name. So if you want to return a specific value, you can add the where statement. So where first name is the column, and then like the value that you insert in this like, and you need to put them also in a single quotes and return the first name where it's like something. So if we just put where it's like John, but it is cap sensitive, so it will need to be capital, this will only return that. So if we change this to last name, it will return the last name where the first name is like John. So in this case, it'll be John Jones. So if we execute that, Jones will come up. And you can also change this to all. So we want to select all columns in all data where the first name is John. So now if we run that, it returns everything where John is the first name. So we could also do an equal, where we could do age is equal to 60. And in this case, it's going to return all of the data from this data value that we inserted, which will be Tim Johnson. So if we just highlight it, click, since the age is 60, it returns that. And so we're going to drop this table, which is how you get rid of a table. So we're going to get rid of this example. You can just hit drop table as a syntax and then the name of it. First table. If you mess up creating a table, you can just highlight this, execute. So now when we refresh this, go to schemas, go down to table, there's nothing there, which is what we want. And that's all I'm going to go over in this video. If you'd like to see more, like, subscribe, comment. My next video will be how to import data. So instead of adding a bunch of values, we can import it from an Excel file, which will make creating large SQL queries in just large data sets, useful instead of just manually inserting them all. And thanks for watching.